AuthorHouse presents The Anagram. Written by Emilia Paredes and narrated by Fran, Gregory. On the outskirts of London lived a mysterious 9-year-old girl named Leonie. Leonie loved her name because when people heard it, they said, "Wow, such a beautiful name." And when they told her this, she felt so happy that the expression on her face was like a swan's. At times, Leonie was very quiet, but at others, she was cheerful and sociable, a cute little girl. She had nice curly hair, almond-shaped eyes, and skin the color of a delicate blend of milk and chocolate. Leonie was so tall and thin, she looked like a figurine. Do you know what I mean? Leonie's house was near the River of Welsh Harp, a lovely place in London frequented by many people. On occasion, Leonie and her family went to the river to share bread with those who lived there. Yes, those who moved in and out of the river, such as ducks, mice, and small animals like those. They would throw bread into the water, looking like happy fools, and when the ducks and geese saw this, they would swim towards the breadcrumbs in single file, looking like a screensaver. And what can I tell you about the daring mice that roamed the banks of the river? The mice would jump to catch the breadcrumbs before they fell into the water. That was so cute, it seemed like a planned exhibition. Believe me. One early morning, while hurling breadcrumbs to the geese that lived in the waters of the Welsh rivers, Leonie kept hearing a girl's voice, which said to her, "Come, come, Leonie, come." But Leonie couldn't see the girl anywhere. Drawn to the voice, Leonie went in search of the girl and left behind her family. Leonie left her parents and went down to the ground in search of the voice that called her, where she saw sights that were new to her and heard music coming from somewhere. "I like this place. It is full of beautiful flowers. There are colorful butterflies and bees tasting sweet roses. It is spectacular to see how they dance to this melody. But tell me, why don't you let me see you?" Leonie asked the invisible girl. "It is better that you just listen to the singing of the birds, to the sound of the river, and enjoy this place. I guess you don't know the mysteries of this river. Come on, so that I can show you more," the invisible girl said to Leonie. "Incredible! It's a small crystal river. It is magical. And who is that beautiful girl? I can only see her back. She has a long white dress, and her hair is as red as a heart," Leonie commented, asking the invisible girl. Then Leonie tripped on an old log, and while she was falling, she cried out, and her hair became messy. "When I saw that, I put my hands over my eyes. What a scare!" Then suddenly, some roller skates arrived onto her feet like magic. The geese, ducks, and mice also kicked on the ice rink over the crystal river. They danced in circles to the beat of the music, while the butterflies with magical wings and amazing colors did choreographed movements in the air. Leonie enjoyed all that was divinely occurring around her. She was living with new friends and did not want any of this to end. Leonie skated without fear from one side of the river to another, opening her arms to imitate the butterflies, leaving the silent wind caressing her face and playing with her curly hair. "I never imagined living like this. I have so many questions. Tell me, what's going on, please?" Leonie told the invisible girl. What I can tell you, Leonie, is that my story is a little bit sad. You haven't noticed that I am not a happy girl, accompanied but at the same time alone. I just want to ask you if you would mind being my friend. I occasionally come to visit this place, the invisible girl replied. I don't think I'd mind being your friend, but I want sincerity. Let me see your face, and after that, we could talk about it, Leonie said, reaching her hand out to the invisible girl, as one does during a serious talk.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.